Okay, so good day students, let's start with the lecture for today. Fluid, right? So I will give you the introduction first, yeah. So you know that most of the elements around us consist of three phases, which is the gas, solid, and liquid, yeah. And the fourth phase is actually plasma, the star, the components of the stars, yeah. So we have in our surrounding mostly solid, liquid, and gas, where today we will study about fluid, and we know that fluid is related to daily activities such as swimming, water, and also fluid content in our body. And you know that our nation also consists of 70% oceans or water, which means that we are one of the biggest archipelago, yeah, in the world. And also natural phenomena such as floating of the fishes, swimming of the ships, yeah, and also the cycles of plants, the life cycle of animals, and also related to flight, yeah. And also this air, yeah, air cycle around us is due to the fluid flow called conduction, yeah, convection, and radiation. So we can feel the heat of the sun because the sun radiates energy, which then received by the earth, the biota, yeah, the living organism, in the form of direct or indirect energy. For example, the plants can do photosynthesis using sun energy, converting a chemical reaction into the producing energy that can be consumed by the higher stratas of the animal kingdom, yeah, such as human and animals can consume the food from the plants, which is a result of energy converted through photosynthesis, yeah. And also the flow of wind is because of the pressure difference between the temperature also. So the pressure difference is because the different temperature between the sea and the land. And you can see that the cooling process, the heating process is not the same for each object, yeah. So for example, you heat the water and you heat the land, they will not go at the same rate, yeah. They have different speed of heating and also cooling. So this is the cause why there is a temperature difference between the water and the land. We call this the heat capacity, yeah, or the ability to transfer heat, how fast. It depends on the intrinsic properties. Also, blood flow in the body, yeah, is regulated by the blood systems, yeah, also pumped from the from our heart into the whole body through a mechanism called artery blood transport, yeah. And you can see that everything here consists of fluid, yeah, many things. Also in the application of hydraulic instrument, yeah, such as pushing our car into the air using this hydraulic system when we want to wash our car, and also in transportation when we want to pass a big ship through a channel, yeah, like Panama Channel or the Suez Channel in Egypt, we usually use this hydraulic system, right? And we also have future technology, for example, floating houses, floating objects like this, where we can have our like office in floating office, yeah. This is very interesting. Also in the subject of nanotechnology, we have this kind of ultra fine bubble where we can, for example, produce increase in the health of some plants, yeah. And also we can increase the efficiency of water quality and something like that. So there are many applications in the future, and also this nano bubble can be used for tea flow or for producing less friction in electronic devices, yeah, and home appliances also for washing. And water quality monitoring can be done with various technologies, yeah. For example, monitoring tsunamis or monitoring many things that we can do using this principle. Also in transportation, you already know submarines. They are very heavy, but they can float under the water and even go surface into the top of the water. Yeah, they can go to the surface of the water too. And this all is because of the control of the pressure, control of the density of this submarine, you can see. And they want to go up, they have to put the water out from their system. They have this kind of vessel where they can insert and out and outsert this water inside their submarines. So when they want to go down, they fill their empty space with water. And when they want to go up, they will release the water out again. They have this pressure pump. Yeah. And if this is a damage, this can also produce a tragedy. Yeah? Like what happened before is that the pump is not working. So for all submarines, sometimes the danger of submerge into the bottom of the ocean is real. Yeah? So we have to take care of this. Also, pressure technology you can produce for the healthcare. For example, why you have to put the infus bottle above you is related because the pressure of the air is important to produce the infus liquid to go into your body. Yeah. So when you put the infus in the air, this means that there is a pressure difference. Yeah, there is a difference between the pressure above and below. And because of that, the water, the blood will not go up, yeah, because they will, the blood always go up to the low pressure, will go to the low pressure. So the blood will be going from the high pressure to the low pressure, yeah. And because the infus has higher density, the infus wants to go the infus wants to go from the low pressure to the high pressure because the density is lower. Yeah. So the point is that the blood will not go into the infus because of the pressure difference. Yeah. So there are also two kinds of flow, which called the laminar or linear flow, and also this turbulent flow. Yeah, it's important when you want to consider flow into the pipe and also in the airplane transportation. You have to avoid the turbulent current in the air because it can produce some discomfort, yeah, or produce some problems if you go into the highly turbulent area. Yeah. And also in the stock market, this is very, very interesting too, that you can probably see the pattern of the stock market is going upwards and downwards is based on some kind of fluid equation. Yeah, so this is actually a random process, but it somehow can be a little bit modeled, even though we don't know the future. Yeah, but at least we can predict the pattern. Yeah, predict the pattern. So, and also you can read by yourself the difference between the laminar and turbulent is given by the limit called the Reynolds number. Yeah, so this is the Reynolds number is the Reynolds number is the difference between the linear flow and the turbulent flow. Yeah, it depends on some parameter. This Reynolds number depends on the inertia force and the viscous force given by the parameter here, which you can read by yourself. Yeah, this is just an introduction for the main slide. Yeah, are there any question until now? Okay, this is the introduction. I think you already get the point. Also, it's interesting to see this insects can float in the water surface, yeah, with only the with their feet. Yeah, this is because there is the called the surface water stress, yeah, atau tekanan permukaan, ya, surface energy, tekanan permukaan. This is caused because the atoms are not arranged in the symmetric way, In the surface, there is atom below, but there is no atom above. Therefore, the surface must be stronger because it will compensate the loss of atoms that are not present above the surface. Okay, now I will go with the next slide. Can you all see my screen and the presentation?
Yes, sir.
I will move on with the slide, yeah. So there are some topics for today, which I hope that I can finish in half an hour. So we have this density, pressure, Pascal principle, Archimedes, Bernoulli, and also the continuity equation. Yeah, you will learn this today, and you know that the matter consists of three phases. Yeah, gas, solid, and liquid. From these three phases, gas and solid and liquid, gas and liquid are categorized as this fluid. So what is fluid? Fluid is a substance. When we put into an object, it will follow the shape of the object. So in this case, when you put water into a glass, the shape of the water will follow the shape of the glass. So it's the same with the air. Yeah, it will follow the shape of the balloon, for example. And one of the important concepts that you have to understand in studying this fluid is the concept of density. Why you have to understand concept of density is because density does not depend on the mass. Okay, I repeat, density doesn't depend on the mass, but it depends on the ratio between mass and volume. Yeah, density doesn't only depend on the mass, I mean, but depends on the mass and volume. So therefore, for example, when I ask you the question, which is heavier, right? Like wood or water, yeah. This is not easy question. Or for example, which is heavier, gold or water, yeah. So I think most of you will say gold is heavier than water, right? This is because you measure in the same volume. But actually, I can say that water can be heavier than gold if the volume of the water is larger, right? So the thing that is different is not the volume, not the mass, but the density. So when I ask you what is heavier, the density of gold or the density of water, the answer is clear. The answer is the density of gold is larger than the density of water. Yeah. So this is the reason in fluid we use the density concept. Yeah. Because we also will require this concept for determining whether an object will fall down or sink, or whether it will go to the surface of the water. Yeah, for example, here example, we have 3 kilograms of the rock enter into a bucket, and the bucket has an area of 0.025 meters square. So there is a change in the volume of the bucket, yeah, because we insert some rocks. So how is the density of the rocks? This is easy question, right? Because the density is defined as the mass divided by the volume. You already know the mass. And yet what you call need to recalculate is just the volume. Yeah, how to determine the volume? The volume is determined by what? The volume is determined by, yeah, rho is equal to what? Oh, sorry. Rho is equal to the mass divided by the volume, all right? Mass of the rock divided by the volume of the addition. So the volume of the addition is the increase in volume, which is the area times the different height, yeah? This is 0.025 times. Sehingga tinggi permukaan air meningkat 0,0. Nah, this is not clear ya. Tinggi permukaan air meningkat itu artinya menjadi 0,06 ya, berarti 0,01. Ya. Artinya there is a change from 0.5 increase 0.06. So 0.5 increase into 0.56 ya. So this is 0.06. Okay. 0.06 after you calculate, you just put this here, yeah, and you get the answer. It's not so hard. And then the next one is we try to study about pressure. What is pressure? Simple, force divided by area. Yeah. Therefore, the pressure depends on the area. So in this sense, you can see that a duck will be easier to move in the water than the chicken, because the chicken has the low area, yeah, because they move like this, yeah, and the duck will move like this. So for the chicken, it's more easy to move in the land, whereas for the duck, it's more easy to move in the water, yeah. So also when you are given some fascination, yeah, which is more painful, of course, if the area is smaller, yeah, you will see that the force will be more easy to go, yeah. So with a small area, there is no need to put high force, yeah. But still, it feels more pain, yeah. It feels more pain. But either way, I don't wanna be given for the needle, yeah. But in emergency case, you have to take it. So which is more painful? The smaller one, yeah. The smaller area. So what is air pressure? Air pressure is given by the atmospheric pressure, because you know that in the air, yeah, this is the surface, and in the air above there we have this air, yeah. Air is means udara, yeah, and they will give us pressure, which is 1 atm. It's around 10 to the power of 5 pascal, yeah, or newton per meter square. So because of the air is putting some pressure on you, you feel this called the atmosphere pressure. And this atmosphere pressure is also always present whenever we are in the earth, yeah. So even if we are underwater, we feel this air pressure, but usually we just calculate the water pressure. Okay. So also you can measure the difference between the pressure above and the thresholds between pressure below. Yeah. There is a difference in pressure. So the pressure below is stronger than the pressure above. The difference of the pressure is given by this, right? So the difference of the pressure is given by this formula here, which we call this called the, if we are underwater, then this is called the hydrostatic pressure. We call this hydrostatic because the water above us is still or static. So we call this hydrostatic pressure. And this hydrostatic pressure depends on the density, gravity, acceleration, and the height from the surface. Yeah, from the surface. So you see that even though, for example, the pressure, we are in this like this area here, yeah. Yeah, this is the water surface, and this we are here in this position now. So the height must be calculated from this, yeah, from the water surface. So this is the height is from this point. This is here. So the height is from the surface of the water, even though if above you there is like soil here, yeah. But for the calculation, you have to use from this point to the surface of the water. So we can also measure pressure using manometer. Yeah, this is the classic barometer, and this manometer height is given by this instrument here, calculated from the bottom to the top. Yeah, and this is usually we use like a liquid. Yeah. Yeah, this liquid can be like mercury or something like that. So you can use this kind of device. So and then next, yeah, this is the example, yeah, where we can calculate the total pressure. This pressure here is called the hydrostatic pressure. Sorry. This is the ATM pressure, yeah, or the atmosphere pressure. Because we have also this atmosphere here pressing us from the air, and then we have this water pressure here. Yeah, so we have this here, and we have also this from the atmosphere pressure. And then the total pressure is, of course, we just need to add, yeah. This is like 10 to the power of 5 pascal, Mrs. Huang, the rho GH, we know that the density of water in meter is 1000. Yeah. So this is around 5.5 to the power of 4. Yeah. Right? Yeah. So we have around 15.5 to the power of 4, which is equal to 1.55 to the power of 6. Yeah. To the power of 5. This is this value here. Yeah. So we can calculate this formula. What is the pressure in B? This you can just follow the slide here. This is the same, yeah. So the pressure here is the same as the pressure here, and the pressure here is the same as the pressure here, yeah. So because they have the same height, this is one of the examples, yeah. What is the difference between the blood pressure of the aorta and the artery? If you lie horizontally, you have the same height, yeah. Then the difference of the height is zero, and the difference of the pressure is zero. So if you lie down, actually there is no net pressure, yeah. But if you stand up, then there is a difference between aorta and artery, which is 1.35 meter, yeah. Estimation can be different in each person. Because of this kind, you have to calculate the pressure using this formula, rho GH, yeah. You know that the density of the blood is around 1060 kilogram per meter cubic. Okay. Yeah. And also the height is 1.35. So you have this gravity acceleration also 9.8. Therefore, you have the total difference is 1.431 to the power of 4. Yeah. So in this case, we can calculate the change in the pressure between the aorta and the anterior tibial artery. Yeah. So by object in the same height has the same pressure because of the principle of Pascal, where he said that the pressure given in a liquid must be the same in all direction. Therefore, they will cancel out and produce the same pressure in each height, right? So if you see the water surface is always flat. If there is no wind, if there is no tide, of course the water surface must be flat because of the Pascal principle. If the molecule in the surface exert the same pressure on each other, they will produce a flat surface, yeah? Otherwise, there will be bumps in the water. So this also example can you see when you, for example, have a bottle and put the bottle in a certain angle, you will see that the water surface inside the water is still flat. Yeah, it's still flat. So this is one of the reason because of the Pascal principle. And also you can see here, because of the same pressure that must be asserted, therefore you have pressure equals pressure 2. So the F1 divided by A1 must be same as F2 divided by A2. This is used for the hydraulic principle, meaning if you have a smaller A, you only need a smaller force to produce a larger A with this higher force. So with this principle, for the higher area, you can produce higher force only using small area and small force. So this is the principle of the hydraulic system. As you can see in the example here, a pipe that has a U shape, yeah. We have a different area course, and the difference is if the small is 1 and the bigger is 5, it's meaning that force 1 per watt is equal to. Okay. So you can produce 5 times the force of the F1. Meaning you have 100 newton, you can produce 500 newton, yeah, using the principle of this Pascal principle here. So for example, if the force can be 10^5 in the small one, yeah. So it can produce 5^10^4, yeah, 5 kali lipatnya. But of course, it's not always. In many case, it's less than that because of friction, yeah. Pasti ada kayak gesek. This is the ideal case. So, and the Archimedes principle is used to find out whether.
Bunda, abang perlu swap. Buat Sabtu perlu swap.
The originality of
Sabtu perlu swap.
Golden crown. Yeah. So, for example, you have this crown from pure gold or not? They have the density, right? So the pure gold has a different density than the alloy gold, gold oplosannya. So when you have pure density, you can have the information of pure density. You can see in the experiment whether this is true or not. Jadi apakah kerapatan mahkotanya itu sama dengan emas asli kerapatannya? Cara ngitungnya bisa pakai prinsip Archimedes ini. Yeah. So this application of the Archimedes principle you can find by using the calculation here. Yeah. The Archimedes principle means that when you submerge an object in water, then there is always two forces, right? The forces of the weight and the forces we call the Archimedes buoyant force. Yeah. Buoyant itu apung ya, atau gaya apung. Jadi this buoyant force itu kenapa bisa ada? Because of the different pressure between here and between B. Yeah. Jadi karena ada perbedaan tekanan antara di titik A dan B, itu perbedaan tekanan itu sama dengan gaya Archimedes-nya itu. Jadi this Archimedes principle depends on what? It depends on three. Yeah. The density of the fluid and the volume that is inserted. Yeah. Not always the whole volume. Bukan selalu volume total, tapi volume yang tercelup. So the Archimedes principle means that you have to multiply, there is a buoyant force equal to the, nih, kerapatan fluida, bukan kerapatan benda ya, density of the fluid. Density of the fluid, gravity, and also the volume that is submerged, ya, volume yang tercelup atau yang dipindahkan. So, if for example, your volume is 2, and then an animal has also volume of 2. Dua-duanya tercelup di dalam air, maka gaya Archimedes-nya sama. Yeah, it doesn't depend on your density, it depends on the density of the fluid. Yeah. Tidak bergantung pada kerapatan benda, tapi bergantung pada kerapatan fluida. Artinya, if the density of the fluid is larger than the density of your body, then you will go up atau akan terapung ya. Tapi kalau density of the fluid itu lebih kecil daripada density of the body atau objeknya, maka objeknya akan tenggelam. They will drown. They will drown because of the this simple principle ya. Sigma F sama dengan M kali A, which means that if the weight is larger than the gaya apung or buoyant force, then it will produce a downward force ya. Menghasilkan percepatan yang arahnya ke bawah. Yeah. So this phenomena can explain therefore the penggelam, melayan dan terapung. Yeah. So you can also calculate the volume, also the density of the body if you know the density of the fluid, if you know the volume of the fluid total and the volume of the object. Yeah. Nah. Volume apa ini? Volume objek atas itu volume yang apa? Volume yang tercelup. Ya. Yeah. Volume yang tercelup. Jadi di sini kan rumusnya gini. Kalau kita lihat di gambar, if you look at the picture, you have this FA ya, yeah, is equal to W. Kenapa? Karena gaya apung dan gaya berat sama, enggak ada percepatan di sini. Bendanya sedang diam. So, rho g v yang tercelup, rho benda g sama volume benda. Jadi g-nya bisa kecoret, maka rho dari fluida dibagi dari rho benda sama dengan, nah ini rho fluida berarti. Volume benda dibagi volume yang tercelup ya. So, this you can use to calculate the density of the body ya. Jadi Archimedes tahu itu dari mana dia asli atau palsu mahkotanya, dari menghitung massa jenis dari benda.
Bukannya kamu ada language problem?
Dan ternyata it turns out that the density of the crown is not the same ya. Jadi ternyata itu adalah mahkota oplosan. Ya, mahkota oplosan tuh campur logamnya. Ya. This you can also know. This is interesting ya. Putting the object in the oil will cause it to drown in the water we go up. Because the density of the water is around 1. And the density of the oil is around 0.8. Therefore, gaya apungnya lebih kecil pada minyak, ya. Minyak kan berarti rho fluida GV ya. Berarti rho fluidanya pakai yang 0.8. Jadi gaya apungnya sekarang menjadi lebih kecil sehingga bendanya tenggelam. Kalau dicampur bagaimana? Nah, ini menarik ya. Ini sebagian some will be in the oil, some will be in the water. Try to think about this ya. Ya, there are some examples ya. A body floating in the fluid will exert pressure. This is wrong ya. Karena tekanan di atas di bawah tidak sama. Gaya angkat muncul karena perbedaan tekanan. This is correct. So ini salah dan ini benar. Okay. So a block is dismerge into water, yeah. And there is 1.3 in the surface, yeah. So, okay. Yeah, maybe after this we have a break for around 5 minutes, and then you can rejoin because my time zone is on my time limit is 40 minutes. Then I will open a room again, yeah. Please try to join the room again. I will give you a new link, okay? I will give you a new link. Please open the link after the break, like 5 minutes break after now, yeah? Okay. So 1%, this is 2%. What is the massa jenis balok? What is the density of the object? You know, density of the object is in this formula, yeah? And this is the total. So the key gives out. What we wanna find? We wanna find rho b is rho fv tercelup dibagi dengan v benda. V benda itu v tercelup berapa? 2/3 v coret-coret. Rho fluida itu 1000. Jadi jawabannya adalah 2000/3. Jadi massa jenis bendanya 2000/3 atau 2/3 g per cm. So this is how we solve ya. Jangan lupa V-nya V yang tercelup. Jadi kalau bukan yang ini ya, V-nya pakai yang ini yang tercelup. Oke ya. Jadi kuncinya adalah menggunakan hukum Newton ya. Di mana dia bendanya tuh sedang terapung, jadi tidak ada gaya neto ya. Oke. Until this, any question? Oke. If not, we have a 5 minutes break, students. See you in 5 minutes. Please don't leave the lecture. Yeah, just stay for 5 minutes. Take a water, take a drink, make a tea or something, and I will invite you through a new link. Yeah, see you in 5 minutes. Goodbye.
Okay, sir.
All right.